you ever felt.
Are you listening?
Hello everyone. In today's tutorial, we see how you can type inside a really window like this. It's a really nice and easy effect to do. So we see how you can do that inside Adobe Photoshop. Alright, fantastic, so let's get to it. Alright, first you need to download the font I will be using. It's called Billy Typeface. It's a free font. I will make sure to put this link in description below. So you just scroll down and go to here and click so you can download it. And make sure to install it before you open your Adobe Photoshop so you can find it in your find list. Alright, and also I will put a link where you can download this rainy window and other picture of the urban people walking. Will be used too. I really like this picture and I think it looks cool because of the light and the shadow of the legs in here. Alright, now I will just go and open my rainy window in here in Adobe Photoshop. And just open it in a new window and I will go again and I will open my other picture, so we just drag it and open it here and I will just resize it like that. Alright, something like this. Alright, looks cool like this. Now we just it's already in a smart object, but if you don't have it, just right click and choose convert to smart object. But in this case it's already in smart object because I open it directly in the window. Alright, now I will go to filter and choose blur because we need to blur it a little bit so it looks like it's behind the window. So we just go and choose Gaussian blur and I will choose 10 radius and press OK. And as you can see, because it's a smart object, you can always go back to a smart filter and choose the Gaussian blur in here that you just applied, and you can just double click on it and you know you can adjust the blur of your image. Yeah, it's really cool that to know that you have that option. So please cancel. Now I will just change the blending mode to overlay. Now as you can see, it looks like it's behind the glass, but it doesn't look that much, give it that much color. So I will just duplicate it by pressing Ctrl G, and then I will just change the blending mode to soft light. And as you can see, it really give it more interesting color to it, but I think it's too much. We'll make it for like 70 or 60%, maybe 70. All right, looks cool like this. Now we need to type our text, so we just go and choose type in here, the T, and we just one click, and you can, you know, type whatever you want. So we just type miss you like this, or hug you, or hate you, whatever you want. And we just press Ctrl A so we can center it. In here you find the align option, so just click one click in here and the other one in here, and you know you can resize your text into whatever size you want. Now I will take this text in here and I will place it just above the background, and also I will convert it to a smart object. So right click and I will choose convert to smart object. This way we can just keep the text, so maybe we want to change it later. And now we'll apply a liquify filter to it, so we need like to make it looks like it's dropping with the rain in here. So we just go to filter and choose liquify, and keep it in this warp tool in here and make the brush size whatever you want. It depends how you want to make the change. and make the pressure to 100, and I just want to make the E drop more like this, because you know it's handwritten and it doesn't, like, it shouldn't be that perfect. So maybe just, you know, try, like, you know, it's a really fun thing to do, so just, you know, play with it like this. Maybe this is like this, you know, just make it look like it's melting with the window, but you don't, you know, like this. You know, if you feel like you miss it, you can just go and choose these two in here, and you know, just you can make it back to the original, and you know, just go back and just make it melt like that. Just showing you. All right, press OK. Now I will just go and change the blending mode to overlay again, and there we go. We have it in the window. It's looking like it's written. See, it's that easy to do. It doesn't like need that much time to make it. And because we convert to text to a smart object, you can always go back and change it to whatever word we want. For example, like if I double click to it, I can, you know, type whatever I want. Maybe hi, alright, something like that. No, let's say hello. Okay, and press Ctrl S to save it. And then if I go back, I found it saved in here, as you can see. Even make it bigger if I want. It's okay. No. And if you feel like if you find it like this with the Liquify, don't panic. You can just, because we change it to a smart object, you can just always go back and double click to the Liquify in here, and choose this tool in here that, you know, make everything back and how it was. So just like this, and make it back like that, and you know, I can always make my own changes again like this. Yeah, it's really fun to do. It's always cool, like, to work with the Liquify. It's really easy and fun. All right, something like that. Press OK. Maybe I'll just change the E a little bit. Press OK, and there we go. It's really easy to do. So I hope this tutorial was a little bit helpful for you. Don't forget to subscribe and comment, and wait for more tutorial to come. And have a nice day. Thank you for watching.